Hey everyone, I'm Pete, and this is the SparkFun Particulate Matter Sensor, BMV080. It is a tiny little sensor by Bosch, and you'll notice that I'm wearing a latex glove because I don't want to damage this little guy. This can sense PM1, PM2.5, and PM10 particulate matter sizes. It's about 450 times smaller than what's out on the market before. It does not require a fan, because it's actually using this little sensor to shoot lasers in the air and then watch the reflections on the particulate matter and give you a reading. So it's gonna tell you the micrograms per square meter of PM1, PM2.5, and PM10. We're gonna talk about what's needed to use this thing. I'm gonna show the enclosure that it comes in, and we're also gonna do a little demo here with some solder fumes and see the numbers go up. So here we have it inside the enclosure. We designed a custom 3D printed part. See the nice SparkFun flame on the front there. But basically what it's doing is it's holding the sensor inside this enclosure, and then it has a nice optical cover that we sourced as well. So that's protecting the sensor from any particles that might land on it or getting scratched or anything. Yeah, so for my demo, I'm using the enclosed version of the product. And I've got an ESP32 Think Plus, and one of our quick OLED boards to display the particulate matter numbers. And then here is the sensor. And you can see they are all just wired up with quick. That was one thing I kind of wanted to show. On the side of this, we've got an access point to plug in a quick cable. It also does SPI. So if you want to solder up some pins there, you can talk SPI to it as well. But the easiest way is definitely quick. So let's turn this thing on. I'm basically gonna plug in the LiPo battery. Ugh, get that in there. And we got a nice SparkFun flash, and then it says sensor detected, and we are up and running. So for this example, I'm just displaying PM1 and PM2.5. And it has about a 10 second integration time here, so it's gonna sort of do some self-calibration. And those numbers are reading zero right now. That's good. We'll probably see them anywhere from like 1 to 10 in just a normal room like this. But SparkFun has some pretty good ventilation. I can even hear it going right now, cleaning out the air for me, so thanks. What we're gonna do is actually put this next to my soldering iron and see if it'll, oh look, PM2.5, 1 microgram, 2 micrograms per cubic meter. So not a lot. Once we get up into the 30 range, that's where the EPA says it's potentially unhealthy if you see that for up to 24 hours. I think we're doing all right here, hovering around zero. So it needs open air around it. It actually needs 35 centimeters. If we have this thing on a tabletop, if my hand comes within a foot of that, it's gonna say obstructed, yeah. So it just caught it right there. But as long as it has enough air around it, then it can do its thing and read the particulate matter. So let's put this over here, fire up my soldering iron, and I am actually not gonna turn on the fan for the first example, just to see the numbers go up. And we're almost there. What do we got? 500, 600, 710. Iron is hot. Okay, so if I cause a little bit of smoke as if I'm just soldering away here on some project, let's see if I can get that going. There we go. It's up. Just gonna hold my breath while this goes on. The sensor does a whole lot of averaging actually, so it's not super fast to react, but look, here we go. Some PM1, we're up at 33. PM2.5 is up at 80. It's a lot of fumes. I think most of the time when I'm soldering, I'm not creating that much fumes. Okay, so it's gonna take a little time for that to settle down, but we're cruising down, seeing 24, 53. All right, let's try this again, but this time let's turn on the fan. So it's a little loud, not too bad, but we can see right now the room is reading about 6 for PM1, and I'm seeing 11 for PM2.5, 10, 9. I'm gonna do some solder fumes right next to my fan, as I would do most of the time when I'm soldering. And it's gonna suck up most of the fumes here, so we should see those numbers stay relatively the same. I can see they're just hovering around 4 and 9. And you can see that those fumes just getting pulled right into that carbon charcoal filter. Don't forget to tip your tin. Tin your tip. It really does make a soldering iron tip last so much longer. Okay, last thing we're gonna talk about is the actual enclosure itself. So these two parts are what we designed to actually give an enclosure to the sensor, but also mount that optical cover at the perfect height. So whenever handling the sensor itself or the optical cover or the O-ring, definitely recommend using a glove because you don't want your finger oils to get on any of this stuff if you accidentally fumbled with it. We'll see if I don't do that today. All right, so this is all the parts. And we actually assemble this in production at SparkFun. So you will receive the sensor in an enclosure with the optical cover on it, ready to go. So you just need to plug in a quick cable and then run our Arduino library and you will be getting particulate matter readings really easily. But what I'm gonna do is actually take this one apart and put it back together so you can kind of see that whole step. These two things snap together. So on the back side of the enclosure, there are two little chambers here on the side. And if we get a super small precision screwdriver, we can push it into there and then actually pop the tooth out. So we're gonna get just below that. If you zoom on in there and then push in, and then a little bit of angle on that screwdriver caused this side to pop out. And then I'm gonna do the same thing on this side. See, and so now the inner shell of that enclosure is totally free. And what we're gonna do is turn it upside down. Da-da-da. And you can see how all this works. We've got a O-ring. Let me get that little guy out of there. And then the optical cover itself, which is a really small piece of glass. It doesn't let visible through, that's why it's black, but it does let the 850 nanometer radar laser beam through. It is a class 1 laser, I should probably mention that, so it's not really dangerous to look at in any way. Last thing to take this apart, we want to add a little pressure to the PCB downward like this, and then also slide it out of the enclosure. So that way it just pops out like this. And at this point, I want to be real careful and use this glove so I don't accidentally smudge the sensor itself. So that's basically disassembly, and now that gives you good access to the PTH pads, and you could potentially put a row of male headers there and then do your jumper wires to talk to it over SPI. Now that we've got the sensor on its own right here, I do wanna highlight just how small it is. So the previous other options we have on the market are usually about, you know, that much bigger. And it's because they have their own chamber and they have fans involved to move the air over the sensor and stuff. And so the fact that this can do this in open air without a fan is just a really big benefit. Reassembly, basically you take the PCB like we've got here and then you slide it into the slot on the inner shell. So you line it up like that and just it gets a little bit of tension there and then it's actually gonna reach a little locking thing and go. That was me clicking actually, that wasn't the sound of the thing. There is a small slight snap that I love. Okay, and then we are gonna put the glass back on top in its little chamber and then the O-ring right above that. And then you take the outer shell of the enclosure, line up the hole with the glass there, just come straight down. And that was the actual snap. So satisfying. As a mechanical engineer designing the enclosure, that is like, whew, it's perfect. Anyways, we got a perfect amount of tension with these little nubbins on the side here pushing into the outer shell, and it's actually sandwiching the sensor, the glass, and that O-ring with just the right amount of tension to hold everything together for you. And that'll be a nice way to protect the sensor. All of the design files are open source for that enclosure. Did it in FreeCAD. If you didn't hear, FreeCAD just came out with 1.0, which is totally awesome. I'm a lover of FreeCAD. I promote it all the time. We use it around here. Awesome software. Anyways, Yeah, so you can look at those files and you can tweak them to your heart's desire. So if your next project involves air quality or you're looking to do particulate matter sensing of the size PM1, PM2.5, or PM10, and if your project's super tiny, this might be the one for you. So hit up our site and you can see the SparkFun Particulate Matter Sensor BMV080. Thanks, and we'll see you next time. So that's pretty much, what did I say? I could just do it right from, hit up our website, and yeah.